The following violates 802.11 standards. It's intended for research purposes only. Please don't use this as a product or do this really anywhere outside of your own home. Otherwise, somebody like the FCC is probably going to get pretty upset. This is my friend Waffles.
Hi.
And he went to the Chaos Communications camp and he got one of these.
A radio.
And the neat thing is that this is a software-defined radio. It allows you to go see into the RF spectrum without specialized hardware for a specific band. And conveniently, unlike an RTL SDR that I love so much, this one can tune to the 2.4 GHz spectrum, which is where these little guys right here, these ESP8266s, live. Now, the ESP8266s have ESP now, so you can just arbitrarily fling packets out. And because of some work that I did before with ESP no SDK, or 8266 no SDK, whatever the name of that project was, you can also just kind of do these really wacky things and just change the arbitrary PLL for all the clocks inside the chip. And so I was just sitting on Slack last night for MagFest, because we're going to be having swages this year, and I was wondering what happens if you just clock an ESP differently and still try to use the Wi-Fi hardware. And, well, the answer is that, of course, because right now my computer's in monitor mode, when it is transmitting the normal packets, you can see all of them, and they're coming in, and you can take a look. And in fact, I am using 6 megabit per second OFDM 802.11 channel 6, and all of that's fine. But then when it's transmitting these other two, the narrower signals, you can't read them here. And so you're thinking, okay, Charles, you found some sort of glitch in the ESP that breaks everything, that lets you just clock it differently, and for some reason it's still tuned to the right frequency, but now the channel width is narrower. Okay, fine, whatever, except for the fact that then if you do it to a second ESP, like this one right here, and if I set the baud rate to 50 kbaud right there, it happens to work out that that is exactly the frequency for when the ESP8266 is running at its slowest, 32 megahertz instead of 80, that it's still able to receive packets. And so both of these are synchronized, stepping through at the same time. They're different frequencies, and that's frequency of operation. So as you can see, they're transmitting at, well, 80 megahertz, then at 60, and then 32. Now that's the system clock. The actual channel bandwidths are 20, about 16, and about 8, respectively. But as you can see, the actual channels in the OFDM channels are getting narrower and narrower, more and more packed as it's going down, which just seems crazy that the ESPs can somehow still communicate, even though all of that is completely wrong and not even close to what 802.11 is really should be. So this is really neat that somehow by clocking the ESP differently, you're able to just completely violate all of the 802.11 standard stuff, and the ESPs can still talk. So this could mean that maybe they could transmit longer distances. Maybe they'd be able to transmit in different conditions. You'd be able to pack more ESPs into the same 802.11 space. Like, this is some really neat stuff. I don't know if anybody's going to take it anywhere, but I do have all of the source code online at ESP8266 odd clock. And this is using the new ESP82XX stuff to really give you more power and able to do stuff with the ESP that is difficult to do otherwise. Thanks for watching.